We'll normally fire up at 7 o'clock in the morning, and we'll shut down long enough to fuel and service, and then after that, run up till noon. We take our 15, 20 minute lunch break, and they'll run till 5:30. Moving sand and gravel, we're digging usually digging the face out of the wall, and then moving the sand and gravel to our screening plants and separating the sand and the rock. Trying to remove as much sand out of the rock as we can, and then that rock we haul from there, from our screening plants, to our crushing operation. Mainly right now, the aggregate that we're producing out of this pit here is going for our contractors that are doing highway work. We've ran the Kawasaki's and everything, and we've had good luck out of the Kawasaki's as far as performance and stuff. And Hitachi's come around, and we've put some of those in line, and we're having real good luck out of the Hitachi's also. As far as production wise, as good as we've ever had. As far as the operation of the loader and the reliability of the equipment that we run. So, you know, we're running them 65 to 70 hours a week right now. We've had real good luck out of Emerald Machinery as far as getting the equipment we need, and then the service and the help that they give us as far as keeping stuff running.
The 330 is more of a sand and gravel, your bigger construction type deal. Sand and gravel is probably the biggest one because of the size of it. The larger construction guys will use them as some of their stuff in the field, but even that is still moving material and stuff like that on a job site. Somebody that's wanting a mass production type machine. When they rolled into the Z7s on the Kawasaki and then into the Hitachi, that they've done a good job of actually doing and giving operator comfort. There's a lot of features in there that give that operator comfort, and the guy's in it for 10 to 12 hours a day. You want him to feel comfortable so that he wants to get up and get in that machine every day, especially you saw where they're running 6 days a week at certain job sites. You know, that's spending 50 to 60 hours a week every week in there, and giving some of those comfort items that they've done with the seats and extra room, that really has helped doing it. And then the visibility, some of the safety issues, they offset the muffler and their air cleaner on the backside to give a little bit better visibility. The location of the backup camera is in front of you instead of up to the side or up top like it is in other models, where it's easier to see as you're doing your own operations. So there's a lot of features like that. And then going into the DPF, without having the DPF, they have the SCR systems with no DPF. That's huge. There's only the Cummins engines are doing that, and that's actually a huge feature, because that's one more item that can potentially go wrong, or another cost item down the road. Those DPF filters are quite expensive, so they're not having to replace them and don't have to deal with them. That's something that's actually a good cost savings for Hitachi. So